Okay, we'll start with a chapter, length, time, and mass measurement. So, in length, time, and mass measurement, we are going to measure the length of a given segment or any distance, or time, or mass. But the point is, we are going to measure the length of a given segment or a given distance by the method known as the indirect method. So there are two methods to measure the length of a given segment or a given distance. First is the direct method and second is the indirect method. So for example, if you want to measure the length of a segment which is 1 meter long, let us suppose, you can use meter rod to measure this length, or a distance can be 2 meter or a distance can be 3 meter. You can use the meter rod to measure these distances. Or suppose if you want to measure the diameter of a cylinder, so if you want to measure the diameter of a cylinder, you can measure the thickness of any disc which is very, very small. There are instruments known as vernier calipers and screw gauge with the help of which you can measure the diameter of this cylinder as well as you can measure the thickness of this disc. So these are the method. Yeah, suppose you want to measure these kind of distances which are small and which can be measured with the help of some equipments. For example, meter rod, screw gauge or vernier caliper. But there are certain distances. For example, if you want to measure the distance of moon from earth and you want to measure the approximate distance of moon and earth, for measuring the approximate distance of moon and earth, there is no direct method to measure this distance. You have to use the concept of indirect method to measure the distance between the earth and the moon. Or suppose you want to measure the approximate distance between the earth and the sun. Obviously, there is no direct method to measure the distance between the sun and the earth. You have to use the concept of indirect method to measure the distance between the sun and the earth. And similarly, if the distance is very, very small, for example, you want to measure the radius or the diameter of any molecule. So while measuring the diameter or radius of any molecule, this distance is so small that there is no equipment to measure this radius or the diameter. You have to use the concept of indirect method to measure this radius or the diameter. So our focus in this chapter will be on indirect method rather than the direct method. So it has been classified that if your distance ranges between 10 raised to power minus meter and up to 100 meters, there are equipments available and you can measure these distance, the distance which lies between 10 raised to power minus 1 meter to 100 meter with the help of the direct method only. But if your distance exceeds this certain range, there are certain method which comes under the category of indirect method by which you can measure the distance which is greater than 100 meter. For example, you can measure thousands of meter distance, for example, distance between the moon and the earth with the help of the indirect method. So we are going to focus in this chapter the method used which comes under the category of the indirect method. So first method which comes under the category of the indirect method is known as eco-reflection method. Eco-reflection method means, for example, there is a hill and you are standing here on the road. You want to measure the distance between the hill and the person, want to measure the distance between the hill and himself. So for this, what he will do, he will fire a gunshot, and the bullet will go and the sound will be generated. The sound will go in forward direction, and after having echo, it will be reflected back to the person. So if he measures the time of sound which is moving with the velocity of v towards the hill and coming back with the velocity of v towards the person, if he measures the time taken, which is t for going down and t for coming up, or you can measure the total time also. Let us suppose the total time is t for to and fro motion, and the distance the sound covers from person to hill is x and back from hill to person is x. So total distance covered is 2x, and the velocity of sound is v and covered in time t. So if he finds the time t by some method, so by putting the value of time in this formula as well as the velocity of sound in this formula, he can calculate the distance between himself and the hill. So this is a sort of an indirect method by which you can measure the distance between a person and a hill by the method of equireflection method. So this is one of the method by which he can measure the distance. Similarly, if you want to measure, suppose thickness of a matter sheet. So suppose there is a sheet available. I'm drawing a magnified diagram of a sheet, but this is thin. So if you send a sound, this is a solid structure. If you send a sound from this side, it will go towards the sheet to the other side. After striking this face, it will come back to the person. Again, the distance traveled by the sound with a velocity of v is x, and x in to and fro motion, it will cover a distance of 2x. So total distance is 2x. Covered with a velocity of v, and total time taken for to and fro motion of a sound is, let us suppose, t. So by this method, you can calculate the value of x to be v into t by 2, which is known as the thickness of this matter sheet. This is again the method by which you can measure the distance by the indirect method. This is known as the indirect method, basically. So next is the third indirect method, is known as sonar. And also I want to mention that the time t is calculated by some mechanism. It may be a computerized mechanism, because the speed of sound is enough, is 332 approximately 332 meters per second, which is fast enough that you cannot measure this, the time taken for to and fro motion, by any easy method. You have to use some computerized system to calculate the value of t. So in case of sonar stands for sound navigation and ranging. So sound navigation and ranging means this method is used, and especially this method is used for underwater for detection of rocks and submarines, etc. So in this method, suppose you are underwater and there is a submarine, and the submarine is moving forward. It wants to detect that whether there is a hill or an obstacle in the path of the submarine. So what submarine will do, it will continuously generate some waves in the forward direction. The waves will go in the forward direction, strike an obstacle, and it comes back. If it comes back, it means there is an obstacle. If it do not come back, it means there is no obstacle. So let us suppose there is an obstacle. So what sonar do, that it will send continuously some signal with a speed of light, that is 3 into 10 raised to power 8. It continuously sends some electromagnetic waves out of this submarine, and the wave will go and come and will be reflected back. Suppose x is the distance covered by the wave in the forward direction, and x is the same distance traveled in backward direction. So total distance traveled is 2x, covered with a speed of light c into time t. So if submarine calculates by some mechanism the time t for a wave to go in the front direction and strike the obstacle and come back, so you can calculate the approximate distance x between the submarine and the hill. So this is the method, this is the indirect method by which you can calculate the distance of submarine and a hill. Next indirect method is radar. So radar stands for radio detection and ranging. Radio detection and ranging. So in this, the word radio stands for that there is an antenna which will send continuously in upward direction, in every up direction upwards, the radio waves. Radio waves. And radio waves are some electromagnetic waves which travel with the speed of light 3 into 10 raised to power 8 meters per second. So these waves are sent into the space, which are then reflected by any aeroplane. Suppose there's a plane going and you are sending some waves. If this wave go and comes back, it means there's some aeroplane or rocket flying in the sky. And if the signal comes back, so we calculate the distance of to and fro motion 2x and speed of light is c and time is t, we can approximate calculate the distance of the aeroplane from the ground. So this is basically the concept used in radar system, which is again an indirect method to calculate the distance of plane or rocket from the ground. So next indirect method is to find height of distant object by triangular method. This you have covered in your 10th class, that let us suppose you want to measure the height of the building, and suppose this is theta angle of elevation, you are standing x distance apart. So you can use tan theta is equal to h divided by x, and by knowing the value of theta and x, you can calculate the value of h to be x tan theta. So this method also comes under the category of the indirect method. Next is same example, triangular method. This is the h, and suppose this is angle of elevation theta 1, this is angle of elevation theta 2. You are x distance apart from position A and B, and you want to calculate the value of h. So again, you have done this thing in your 10th or 9th class, that you take two triangles. First is the whole triangle, this complete triangle. Second is this triangle. You calculate this whole distance, you calculate this distance, and you subtract these two distance, and you will get the distance of x. This is again the method which comes under the category of indirect method and triangulation method. You can, by the help of this triangulation method, you can calculate the indirect distance h from the given data. Next is to measure the size or diameter d of a moon. So this is the one of the important method to measure size or distance of moon. So first we'll calculate to measure the size by size we means diameter. So we are going to measure the diameter of moon. For this we use the concept of the sector. Suppose this is Earth, this is moon, this is diameter d, and suppose I'm standing here and the diameter is making an angle of theta on the Earth. So this is d, this is theta, and this is s. So if I know the value of s, that is distance of moon and Earth, if I know this angle theta, I can use the formula angle is arc divided by radius. Radius means s. So you can calculate d is equal to theta into s. By this you can approximate calculate the diameter of the moon. But this is again indirect method, and this will give approximately the diameter of the Earth. Diameter of the moon. So this is one of the method by which you can calculate the diameter of the moon. Next important method is to measure distance of moon or any astronomical object by a method known as parallax method. This is the very important method which can come in your school exam, parallax method. So what is parallax? First we'll discuss. Suppose this is my left eye, this is my right eye, and this is the object which is seen by both the eyes. The distance between my left and right eye is supposed B, and this object is at a distance of approximately S and S from my right and left eye and making an angle of theta. So by again using the concept of angle is arc by radius, we can calculate this angle, which is known as a parallax angle. This angle is known as a parallax angle. So this method is known as a parallax method, and the angle is known as a parallax angle. So by this method, what we can do, we can calculate the distance of some astronomical object from the Earth. How? For example, this is Earth. So problem is that our left and right eye are very close to each other. So B is very, very small, and this angle is very, 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 very small. What we do, suppose this is an astronomical object whose distance is to be measured, we take two different locations on the Earth. Let us suppose somebody is standing here and somebody is standing here, and distance between them is B. This person acts as a left eye, this acts as right eye. So I want to calculate the approximate distance of S from L and R. This is the parallax angle theta, and suppose I draw a vertical line from L, I draw a vertical line from R, and this is going up to infinity as these are vertical lines. So if I calculate this angle phi 1, if I calculate this angle phi 2, which can be easily measured at two locations L and R, so by alternate angle, this angle is phi 1, this becomes phi 1, this is phi 2, this becomes phi 2. So total angle at O becomes theta is equal to phi 1 plus phi 2. So by calculating the value of phi 1 and phi 2, I can calculate the whole angle theta. I can apply the parallax method. Angle is arc by radius. So I know the value of B. I know the value of theta, which I have calculated, phi 1 and phi 2. I can calculate the approximate distance of S to be B divided by theta. So by this method, this is the indirect method known as a parallax method, by which we can calculate the approximate distance of any astronomical object from the Earth. So these all are indirect methods which we have discussed, but in these methods we have calculated the large distances. Now we are going to discuss the indirect method to calculate very, 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 very small distances. The first method to calculate the very small distance is Avogadro's hypothesis. Avogadro's hypothesis. According to Avogadro's hypothesis, the actual volume occupied by the atom in 1 gram of a substance is 2/3 of volume occupied by 1 gram of substance. So actual volume means every matter is made up of atoms. So if I calculate the actual volume of atom, this is my actual volume. And if I calculate the whole volume by method, density is mass by volume, so volume is equal to mass divided by density, I will get the whole volume of the matter, which is not my actual volume, because actual volume is occupied by all the atoms. So this formula will give total volume including the volume of these voids. Empty spaces are known as voids. So what we are going to do is, suppose we consider m grams of mass, v is the volume, and capital M is the molecular weight of the substance, and n is the Avogadro's number. So number of atoms in a given sample can be calculated by n capital M into small m, because you are given m grams of substance, m is the molecular weight, n is the Avogadro's number. You have done in a chemistry, in physical chemistry, number of atoms can be calculated by this formula. Let us suppose small r is radius of atom, then actual volume, if I want to calculate actual volume of atoms in a given sample, which is equal to the volume which we have calculated into 4 by 3 pi r cube. Because volume of each atom is 4 by 3 pi r cube, where r is the radius of the atom. So we have calculated number of atoms. So number of atom into volume of one atom gives total volume. So, but according to Avogadro's hypothesis, this volume, this should be M. This volume, which we have calculated, which is the actual volume, is 2 by 3 times the total volume. And this total volume can be calculated by mass by density. This is capital M, 4 by 3 pi r cube. So by using this method, we can calculate the radius capital R cube. So capital R cube becomes 2 times capital M N 4 pi rho. So 2 and 2 gets cancelled. Capital M 2 pi N rho. So R comes out to be M 2 pi N rho whole raised to power 1 by 3. So by this method, you can calculate the value of the radius of the atom. The next indirect method which we'll discuss is to calculate size of a molecule of a liquid. So which liquid we are going to use, or we are going to calculate the size of a molecule of an acid which is known as oleic acid. So we are going to calculate the size of the oleic acid. As the size of oleic acid is large in size, or quite large in size, so this can be calculated by this indirect method. So for this, suppose a solution of say 1 divided by 500 concentration of oleic acid is taken and is dissolved in 500 centimeter cube of alcohol. Suppose n drops of solution is taken and poured on surface of water. So what we have done? We have taken 1 by 500 concentration of oleic acid in 500 centimeter cube of alcohol, and we took n drops of solution and poured on the surface of water. So what will happen after a passage of time? Whole of the alcohol will evaporate and only oleic acid remains on the surface. So we calculate A as the area of a film developed by oleic acid. So what we have done here, we have taken a container of water, we poured this solution and only oleic acid remains on the top of the surface and rest is water. The alcohol gets evaporated. And suppose this is the area A of the film of the oleic acid developed. So volume of oleic acid in n drops will be equal to n is number of drops, v is the volume, and total volume is n into v. But we are calculating the volume of oleic acid, so concentration of oleic acid is 1 by 500. So total volume of oleic acid becomes n into v into 1 by 500. Suppose T is the thickness of film of oleic acid. So if T is the thickness of the film of this oleic acid, so if we calculate the volume of this portion, we'll get area into thickness is the volume. But we have already calculated volume of the oleic acid to be n into v into 1 by 500. So we calculate the thickness of oleic acid to be n into v upon 500 into a. If we calculate the thickness, so thickness here means the diameter of the oleic acid. Because a very thin layer of oleic acid is formed, only one molecule is used here in making the film. So this one molecule means T is the diameter of the molecule. So by this method, we can calculate the diameter of the oleic acid. So this was the measurement of the length by indirect method. Next part covers the measurement of mass. So it has been defined that the mass can be defined or can be calculated by two methods. First is inertial mass, and second is gravitational mass. So if I want to calculate the value of inertial mass, suppose there is a mass, F force has been applied and A is the acceleration, we can apply F is equal to mass into acceleration, the law of inertia, we can calculate the value of mass to be force divided by acceleration. This is the inertial mass of a body. But if the weight of the body is suppose 80 Newton, so weight is equal to mass into G, G is acceleration due to gravity. So here I'm calculating the value of mass with the help of acceleration due to gravity. The mass calculated by this method is known as the gravitational mass, in which we are using the concept of acceleration due to gravity, that is the force of the gravity. But here acceleration due to gravity or force of gravity is not used. Here the concept of inertia is used. You can use any of the method while calculating the mass, either inertial mass or the gravitational mass. The value of mass will come out to be same, but the method for calculating mass is different. So these are the inertial, and this is the difference between the inertial and the gravitational mass. So this is basically the concept of length and mass measurement, and regarding the time can be calculated by direct method. You need not have to study the concept of the indirect method to calculate the concept of the time. So by this we finish our chapter of length and time and mass measurement.